Hello children, I'm back with another lesson in maths, ascending and descending numbers. Children, have a look at these pictures and try to see if you can notice any changes, especially the first picture and the last picture. Look at them. Do they look the same? No, they don't. Then what do you see? You see a small baby. In the next picture, you see a young boy. The third picture is of a young man who's busy running to his work. And the last picture is a picture of a grandfather. So you see, the pictures are placed from small to big. Now in maths, when it's small to big, we call them ascending numbers. They are in ascending order. Look at these pictures, children. What do you notice? Correct, you notice animals. Animals moving downwards. We have horse right at the top and honeybee right below. So these animals are arranged from big to small. We have horse, then the dog, then the frog, and then the bee. These are arranged from big to small. And in maths, when numbers or things are arranged from big to small, they are called descending order. What are they called? Descending order. Let's play with numbers now. We have numbers 245, 213, 230. We have to arrange them in ascending and descending order. Remember, ascending order means small to big, correct. So we begin. We have the smallest number here, 213. The next number is 230. And then we are left with 245. So that's how the ascending order is arranged. Now we will arrange the descending order. So remember, descending order means correct, from big to small. So the biggest number here is 245. Now between 213 and 230, the biggest number is 230. And then we are left with 213. And that's how we have arranged the numbers in their descending order. Our next set of numbers are 538, 820, 291. Now, children, remember, look at the number or the digit in the hundreds place. You can immediately make out which number is the smallest. Correct. So we have 291. The next number, which is the smallest, is 538. And then we have 820. Now in descending order, we write the last number first. So the biggest number is 820, then followed by 538, and then the smallest number, 291. The next set of numbers, 999, 745, 600. Again, look at the numbers in the hundreds place and you will be able to make out which number is the smallest. We have 6, which is the smallest number. So, 600 will come first. Then, we will have 7, which is the smallest. So 745 is the next number. And then The last number which remains is 999. That's how we got our ascending numbers. Now in the descending number, the biggest number comes first, and that is 999. The next biggest number is 745. And then we are left with 600. That's how we have arranged our numbers in ascending and descending order. Here is Mojo. And Mojo has got some numbers which we have to arrange them in ascending and descending order. So let's get started. 5,000, 7,000, 2,000 are the numbers. In ascending order, the smallest number comes first. So here comes 2,000 for the smallest bone. Then we have 5,000 and then the 7,000. So in ascending order, we have 2,000, 5,000 and 7,000. Now descending order is very simple. So now the biggest number first, and we put 7,000 first, followed by 5,000 and then 2,000. I'm sure, children, you're having fun with numbers. We have some more to go. And here we have 1,085, 6,549 and 4,328. Remember the rule. In ascending order, we have 1,085 that goes first, since it's the smallest one. Next, followed by 4,328. And then we have 6,549. This is our ascending order. Let's see, the ice cream melts and we get a descending order. We have 6,549 followed by 4,328 and the smallest number last, that is 1,085. The last set of numbers, we have 3,524, 3,110, 3,807. Since we have 3 in the thousands place in each of the numbers, we move on to the number in the hundreds place and see which number is the smallest one. Correct, we have 1 as the smallest digit, and so 3,110 is the first number, that is the smallest number, followed by 3,524, and then we have 3,807. That's how we get our ascending order. In the descending order, we write the biggest number first. So we have 3,807, then we have 3,524, and finally, the smallest number, 3,110. So children, don't you think it is easy? Yes, but you have to practice. Only when you practice, you're going to be perfect in doing these sums. I'm sure you had fun with ascending and descending order today. Just as I told you that practice makes a man perfect. So here are some sums which you will practice and be perfect in solving ascending and descending order of numbers. Have fun!